So today we discuss about second plant, Cerbera. In the cultivation practice, and their process, some techniques, diseases, and their pest. This is the detailed structure and study about the Cerbera plant. Cerbera plant is a commercially very important plant in trees. It is a very a graceful flower that is why used to as a cut flower crop for the decoration purpose and other purpose or occasions in the various places where it has to be near. Cerbera flowers have wide range of colors. There are different colors, including yellow colors, orange, cream white, pink, brick red, terracotta, and various others, intermediate, or even also in a combination of the two colors or three colors are also produced by the growers. Bicolor flowers looks like very beautiful. And that beautiful structure of the flowers has to be demand in the market. And depending upon the demand of the market, growers has to be grow the different varieties of the Cerbera flowers. Cerbera flowers have a long stalk, but it is very thin and lippy. So handling is very carefully. In greenhouse cultivation, there is a very important point about the soil where they have maybe cultivated on some soilless media. That means without soil. How? With the using of cocoa peat. There are some limitations or advantage also. Cerbera cultivation cost increase in soilless media. About 20 to 30% cost has to be increased. Production is higher in soilless media compared to the soil media. That means these earnings of the money increased due to the production is increased. Third one is required very close monitoring. Then soilless media is suitable for the large area. Say about more than 2 acres area also includes. In India, mostly soil media preferred for Cerbera cultivation due to electricity and irrigated water quality. So these are the most important points. The major Cerbera plant producing states in India is almost over Maharashtra, Karnataka, Gujarat, Tamil Nadu, West Bengal, and Himachal Pradesh. What are the cultivation requirements? Number one is the soil structure, providing a soil for the cultivation. There are two primary factors are considered here while selecting of the soil. What are these? The soil pH must be maintained in between the 5.5 and 6.5. And soil salinity level does not exceed 1 ms per centimeter. This is most important for better root growth and better penetration of the roots. The soil should be highly porous and well drained. Each and every cultivation in the crop, a particularly floriculture crop, has to be need well drained structure and texture of the soil. Here also soil has to be sterilized with the help of chemicals. Some chemicals method, some other methods, some steam methods, or even also sun methods. Steam method is not possible for our area practically. But sun method is important. We look at here. In this case, what happened? The plastic seeds has to be covered on the soil about 4, 6 to 8 weeks. Automatically, the heat has to be increased and totally pathogens, which are soil-borne pathogens, are died. In chemical methods, advantages is the most important because of the hydrogen peroxide with silver is sterilized by this soil. Weapon, another one, chemical is also important for the chemical methods. So number of things are here important for the soil sterilization. Another thing is that here, how to prepare the bed. Bed preparation is required, and for this purpose well-drained soil is required. So they grow on the raised beds. The dimensions of the beds has to be fixed. It should be height about 1.5 feet, width 2 feet, and between the two beds there is a particularly 30 centimeter or 1 feet is a requirable space. If recommended quantity of soil along with the biological composting, that is the farmyard manure, this is most important, which increase the soil texture and the give more amount of the nutrition gradually and continuously to the plants. Say for example, neem cake has to be used, and also in Indian cultivation practice, this neem cake is always to use 1 kilogram per meter area has to be added during the bead preparation, and it has to be prevent the attack of the nematodes, that is the root disease. All the materials must be mixed well, and then preparation of bed has to be completed. Another thing is the planting. The before gerbera planting, selecting the wood gerbera variety is the most important. And as per the market and market demand, and our property particularly, we have to be select right color, right the variety. It is most important. Number of things here, number of varieties are also present in this case. The combination of the colors is most important. So in India, there is 5 to 10 gerbera plant supply nurseries are available from which we have to be cultivate. Buy these plants and planted in the greenhouse or poly house. Then transplanting. In transplanting the gerbera plants, the plant crown should be above 1 to 2 centimeter soil level. This is most important. Without disturb any root balls at the base of the plant. Two rows distance must be maintained. As per I already discussed in above, or even also here also I have used here 1.25 feet between the rows, and plant to plant that is the 1 feet. Then what are the fertilizations? Fertilization starts after the 3 weeks of a plantation. Started the grade fertilizer and use a more good result. First 3 months are most important for fertilization. Every alternate day fertilization dose has to be provided the plant is the most important. After 45 to 50 days, flower bed started to grow and the cut flowers had the disbudding operation has to start it and complete the growth of the plant when 16 to 18 fully developed leaves has to be seen on the plant body. And then stop the flower budding cuttings. After this, give productive phase of the fertilizers. NPK is the most important, 2-1-4. And after that, the plants gives the alternate doses of the nitrogen Then again, one of them important thing is watering. The optimum irrigation in small quantities has been offered to the plant with the fertilization. Micronutrients are must be essential to grow very well of the plants. Then number of things, there are number of microchemicals are available in the market. Another one is the harvesting part. As far as harvesting, after 30 to 45 days of gerbera plantation, bud initial started, but the initial bud is very inferior quality. So you have to be understand that such inferior quality bud has to be cut from the plants, and only healthy buds has to be allowed to grow. So these has to be provided the maintenance of the our quality of the flowers, and even also a production of the good quality flowers. This budding helps making the plant strong and healthy. The first flowers harvested after 12 to 14 weeks after the plantation, when it is fully developed, then flowers are harvested. It will be decided that what are the good quality of the flowers. The good gerbera flowers has a stalk length about 45 to 55 centimeter, and diameter of the flower must be 10 to 12 centimeter. This is a good quality for the marketing. Then it has to be cut early in the morning, and evening is the best time for the gerbera cutting. And cutted plant has to be stored in the clean water container. Flowers are very delicate, hence should be carefully handled. Gerbera plants once produce approximately 45 flowers per year. The intra-cultivation practice is also essential for good health and protection of the plant from the pest and various diseases. Weeds are thoroughly and continuously or periodically removed from the places where the plants has to be cultivated. Raking of soil is required for the easy aeration in the soil, generally twice in the month. The dry and old infested leaves must be removed from the poly house to prevent the gerbera from attacking different types of the microorganisms or pathogens and their growths. What are the diseases and pests? As far as diseases and pests has been concerned, there are different types of the diseases. One of them is root rot. It is a soil-borne disease caused by Pythium and Rhizoctinia. The soil sterilization gives good control of this root rot. Second one is foot rot. This disease is also a soil-borne disease, and it can be also controlled by soil sterilization method, generally with Vepan at 100 ml per meter square. Third one is blight. Blight disease is also known as grey mold disease, and is caused by botrytis, which kills young growing tissues. And for the their control spray, 0.7% Captan and TMTD or 0.7% Cupron at 8 to 10 days interval. Another one is the most important disease where commonly observed in our area, that is the powdery mildew. And this powdery mildew has attacked by two fungi, Erysipi and Viridium fungi, has to be attacked. So gerbera producing a white powder coating on the leaves and foliage, and due to this the photosynthesis process has to be disturbed, and production of the leaves has to automatically decreased down. So good control was obtained before the flowering with contact fungicide and elements of sulfur and Dinaka chemicals has to be sprayed. So these are the diseases. Some pests are also disturbed the plant. There are about five pests or insects. One of them is the most important, that is the fly. This fly is very dangerous, infested, because of white flies sucking the sap and kill the leaves. And it has been controlled by biological control methods using Enchiridia formosa insects and the use of BSC powder sprays or aerosol smokes or Parthion and Malathion sprays are most important for this white fly. Leaf miner is another fly, and it is a very serious pest of the gerbera. The larvae born into the leaf and make irregularly shaped tunnels or blotches on the leaf. Generally, they are light yellowish in color or tan to brown in color. And it has to be controlled by spraying dimethoate at 1%, give good result. Another third one is mites. Greenhouse growing gerberas are often attacked by this Hemitetrasonthamus latus, and this second one is mites, which has to be developed on the leaves and flower buds was adversely affected, and the flowers are malformed. And due to the malformation of the flowers, there is no use in the market, no value in the market. So it has to be controlled by spraying the plants with 20% of endrine at 200 ml per 1000 liter, and further applications after the 4 weeks. Another one is aphid. This insect infests young leaves mostly and causes injury to the sucking the sap, and which results in distoration of the tissues. And for the control, we spray the fumigation. Another one is nematodes. Nematodes are root knot nematodes, occasionally serious in cultivation of the polyhouse gerbera. The use of this sand at 800 or 1000 ppm or mocap is the most important chemicals for the controlling of the nematodes. So this is about the cultivation of the gerbera plant. तर बाळांनो, दुसरं प्लांट रोजनंतर जे आहे ते मी तुम्हाला सांगितलं की जर्बेरा प्लांट, आणि जर्बेरानंतर मेरीगोल्ड येणार आहे. तर हे कल्टिवेशन सगळी प्रोसेस महत्त्वाची आहे. 10 मार्क्सला प्रश्न लॉंगमध्ये विचारले जातात. डिसीज अँड कंट्रोल मेजर्स जे आहेत पेस्टचे, हे शॉर्ट नोट्ससाठीसुद्धा विचारले जातात. म्हणजे प्रत्येक तिन्ही प्लांट तुम्हाला कंपल्सरी केले पाहिजेत. इट इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट ॲज युनिव्हर्सिटी एक्झामिनेशन. सो Thank you.